You probably remember the 2006 tragedy in Bellevue when a 210-foot tower crane toppled, killing one man in a nearby apartment. After that accident, the state lawmakers directed the Department of Labor and Industries to develop rules that would ensure that all construction cranes were certified annually.
Rye is one of about 50 accredited crane certifiers in Washington, and he's been busy since Washington adopted the new rules requiring all construction cranes to be inspected and certified.
Got the operator's book.
Inspections begin with a review of paperwork, verifying the crane to be inspected has been properly maintained and that records are current. Okay. Then comes a visual inspection of the machinery. Rye is checking that the boom is straight and free of dents or other damage. The shivs are examined, as well as the wire rope, making sure it is the correct size and free of frayed or damaged wires.
All right. Feels good. No burrs.
The new rules don't just call for the cranes to be certified. Crane operators must pass a drug test and must also pass a written exam and practical exam to become a certified operator.
There she is.
Steve Morgan telescopes the boom in so Rye can check for any leaking fluid or other damaged hoses. The next step is a test of the anti-tube lock system, an important safety device meant to prevent catastrophic damage to the crane hoist rope.
That keeps you from running the ball up into the end of the boom and do damage.
Okay, go ahead and do your number one line. There you go. Okay, bring her down.
The proof load test is another required part of the inspection.
To see if the line and the winch break can hold the weight it's supposed to for what the line is rated at.
The crane must hold the weight for a full 5 minutes.
Looking good, keep coming.
Then Rye directs the crane forward 25 feet and back again. The crane must safely carry the load while in motion. Failing this or any other test would mean the crane cannot be certified. The inspection takes a couple hours for this 30-ton crane.
These rules apply to all cranes above the rated lifting capacity of 2,000 pounds. If you have any further questions, please contact us.